This week on the Epic Family Road Trip, we begin season two of our series recapping the first 2 years of our life on the road. Season one went back to the beginning of our journey in June 2015 and ended with us returning from our road trip around North America to our home province of Ontario, Canada, to sell our house in August 2016. Season 2 will be recapping the big step we took in 2016 to live full-time on the road after selling our house and retrofitting our Jeep Wrangler for our future overland adventures. Though we loved our house in Ontario and had made many fond memories there, we were excited to move on and begin this new, exciting, and epic chapter in life.
So our awesome house is completely empty. We've packed everything up. We've given away a lot of stuff. We've thrown a lot of stuff out. We've got a storage bin being stored with a whole bunch of stuff. We've also got a storage unit in Orangeville with all the things that are going up north to the cabin. So closing the door, locking up, and driving away. Mixed feelings, but excited at the same time.
After officially closing the door to our house for the last time, we hit the road and drove south to Texas, where we would attend a business conference. On the way south, we went through some of the Midwestern states that we had missed on our first go-around. Iowa, Nebraska, Kansas, and finally Oklahoma, where we stopped to visit some friends. In sweat we set the storms, in blood we brave the road. While we were visiting, we did some research on places to get our Jeep retrofitted and found Exploration Outfitters in Durant, Oklahoma. Woke up this morning with the sunrise in my
eyes, just like a new day. Water tank.
And then what else you got? I don't know how.
The guys at Exploration Outfitters were incredible in helping us set up our rig with what it needed to sustain us on long journeys and in rough and remote terrain and climates. We headed with the RV to the Choctaw KOA, where we stayed for the next few weeks as the guys at Exploration Outfitters built out the Jeep. My ride's sweeter to meet the one I love. I don't know how and don't know why, but I'll be tough to know my life. After a little while, we drove back up to Exploration Outfitters to see how the Jeep was coming along.
It's a beautiful day in Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma. The temperature's down in the 20 Celsius or like 70 something, and it's very comfortable after last week's scorcher in the hundreds. And we're heading up to Exploration Outfitters to see how they're making out with their Jeep, getting it ready for our trip to New Zealand. So we'll show you some of the progress they're making.
It was so exciting to see the rig coming together and seeing what we would be traveling and living in for half a year in New Zealand on the other side of the planet.
All right, Daniel, so what do we got here?
We got our new Jeep tent. It finally got installed. There's the ladder. He said to put all the bottom loose ones up to the top by pressing these two bottom slots. Moving it higher. Because if you don't, then it'll all slide down if you try and step on it. Once you got your ladder down, upstairs is a nice sized tent. Where about two big people can sleep. There's tons of storage up and there's hanging hooks. Up here's the skylight. You can open this up, folds up and it hooks onto these two. And then you can see the stars at night skies. Then on both sides and the back of the tent, there's windows that you can open up to see outside or let some more light in. Then if we go back downstairs, and in here we got a fridge that you open up by pushing this down. Then on the other side you pull it down and out comes the stove. It's a bit of storage right here.
Yeah.
And then we're lifting this up. Got a pretty nice size fridge and freezer.
Cool.
Right here you can make it colder. You can turn it on, make it hotter. You just push it back in until it clips. And then when this thing's off before we go to bed, right here, there's a table that folds out with a cutting board. And then up here there's some storage for food or water. And also some in here. Right here in the bunker, open this up. Water tank going all the way across for some extra water.
Very nice.
So now it's all hooked up, ready for New Zealand. Can't wait to go camping.
While we were in Alaska a few weeks earlier, we met an overlander who recommended we attend the Overland Expo in Asheville, North Carolina, to learn more about overland travel, shipping our vehicle, gear we might need, and much more. So while the guys at Exploration Outfitters continued with the Jeep build, we started heading to Overland Expo at the Biltmore Estate in Asheville. The team would then meet us in Asheville with the Jeep when they were finished. This was our first Overland Expo, and we camped with our RV in the visitors' camping for the weekend. And fill the paper with the message that it wants to send. Grab it, hold it by its tail before it escapes. It's amazing to look and think back to this time, and to think of how far we have come since then. To think of how many amazing and unforgettable experiences we have had, lessons we have learned, and lifelong friends we have made since coming here for the first time. At Overland Expo, we attended many classes, bought all kinds of gear, checked out the cool rigs, and met so many amazing people that are now our friends. We were so excited to see the Jeep arrive with the team from Exploration Outfitters.
What do you think?
They had hauled it all the way to North Carolina from Oklahoma.
Oh yeah.
What a thrill to see it all rigged out and ready for the countless epic adventures that would be coming our way over the next few years. Stay tuned for next week's episode as we pack up and prepare for shipping our Jeep and gear to New Zealand and get ready to embark on an adventure of a lifetime exploring both islands from Bluff at the southernmost tip to Cape Ranga in the far north.